Has the Hang Seng Index reversed? What are the key levels you need to take note right now? And what are the instruments that you can tap into possible opportunities? These are the three things I'm going to mention in this video. Hello, this is Binnie here, and nice to be doing another video on the Hong Kong stock market. The video is proudly sponsored by Macquarie. If there's one time frame to check on long-term trend, and I would advise to use the weekly time frame. So here I have on the weekly time frame, and why did Hang Seng move up? There are two factors here. Number one is that it broke out of this downward sloping channel that I've drawn in here. So this is the downward sloping channel. So that's the first reason. Now the second reason is that there was a reversal pattern. And where was that reversal pattern? Switch that into a line chart. You can easily find an inverted head and shoulder here, and Hang Seng broke out. But I have one more tips to teach you guys on how to identify a possible long-term trend reversal, and that is when price make a new high. Okay, so for example, we've seen that in this channel here, price has been making a lower high as versus the previous high and a lower high. And this is something that I kept emphasizing on. And each of the lows is actually a lower low as versus a previous low. So what happened here is that we are seeing another one more high point, right? And this high point is higher than the previous high, okay? You see that it make a new high, and this is like a higher high. If we were to draw in a horizontal level here, and price is actually making a higher high. So what does this say in terms of the market? It says that now buyers are willing to endorse a higher price versus the past. All right, so in this case here, price reversed this short-term downward channel that has been in place since 2023 until 2024 and then until right now. So the whole downward movement since like a year ago had been reversed. If you ask me long-term wise whether price has reversed, then my answer is no, because it needs to make a higher high versus the 2023 high here. Okay, so that's about 23,000 price level here. So price would need to, you know, move above this level to show that the bulls are like a lot more enthusiastic. So short term wise or mid term wise, I think that there is a reversal, but there is a need to confirm again with one more thing. Okay, what is the one more thing to confirm? Right, well, price has to make a higher low. So what do I mean by higher low? Probably switching to a daily chart would be more, a little bit more obvious here. Now we've seen that from here onwards, price is making a higher high, right? But you know, if you inspect the nearer trend movement here, there are signs of an uptrend. For example, this is a low, this is a higher low, and this is a high point here, and then this is a high point here, and then this is the higher high, right? So short term, it's moving in this direction, which is an uptrend. But in order to confirm that this uptrend is valid, there are two things that needs to be done. Number one, it has to find a support level. That means that as price starts to retrace, starts to move down, there must be a support level being found. Second, and this support level must be a higher low versus the previous low point. Why is that so? Because there must be a need for the bulls to come back in to buy into a falling market, and they are ready to get into the next wave of a movement. So a higher low is very important to confirm the health of this reversal here. Now the next question would be then, where is this higher low? How can you find this higher low? So there are a few things that can be done. Number one is to look at the historical support and resistance level. For example, this would be one of that key support level, which was about like 17,200 to 300. That would be a key support level here. And the next support level, which I think is a little bit more feasible, all right, or rather, you know, it's a little bit healthy, because you don't want price to move down a lot more. So if price is to move down a lot more, it shows that the strength of this reversal isn't very strong. So I'm hoping that, you know, price can find some support at 18,200, and that would be a good level, because this was a previous high level as well as a previous low. So that's about 18,200. Now if support isn't found here, then the next support will be back into 17,200. Now The other way to find this strong level is to use a Fibonacci retracement. For example, I will draw from the recent low to the recent high to find possible retracement levels, right? And I have two levels marked here. That would be your 62%, which is very, very near to the 17,200. The next level would be 17,875. It's going to be very near to the 18,000 level. So I'm hoping that, you know, in this whole region here, which would be 18,500 to 18,000, could come in as a strong support for Hang Seng, all right, for the boost to make a re-entry into a midterm, I would say it's a midterm uptrend here. All right, coming back to the next question, what kind of instruments can you tap into a possible short-term trading? Because end of the day, right, if you ask me whether Hang Seng has reversed for the long term, my answer is still no, because, you know, as I mentioned just now, there is a need for price to move above 23,000, right? So what are the short-term instruments for trading into Hang Seng? Today, I'd like to introduce more into using warrants. Head to warrants.com.sg, then use the warrant tools here, choose warrant selector. Then under the underlying, go to HSI. There you can see the call warrants and the put warrants. For call warrants, the price will increase as the underlying, which is HSI, increases. And for put warrant, the price will increase if the underlying, which is HSI, decreases in price. Now, in other words, for investors who are bullish on HSI, then choose a call warrant. For investors who are bearish on HSI, choose a put warrant. Following my earlier analysis, investors bullish on HSI can choose the call warrants, and you see a list of warrants here. With the one with the fire logo, this is the trending warrants. This means that this warrant is trading on a tighter spreads as well as having a higher liquidity and sensitivity. Now, in trading, it's also important to identify possible profit target. So in this case here, as I'm looking for price to retrace downwards towards this 18,500 and possibly into the 18,100 here, right, I'd be looking at a short term, which is a near term target at the recent high. Okay, so the price of this recent high is approximately about 19,600 here. I mean, there might be a chance to move higher towards this level here, which is about 20,000 level. That's a round number as a resistance. So really, it's all about having price moving down to a support level and then look for continuation in terms of trend, and then for price to move up to each of that key levels if you're looking at a short-term trading in Hang Seng. If you look at the content of this video, my stand is that probably Hang Seng hasn't reversed in the long term. It still need to close above 23,000. So probably at this moment, we are still in that trading mode, a little bit more like a midterm reversal probably. Right. And as a disclaimer also, that trading in any form is high risk. Please evaluate whether it is suitable for you. Now, do leave also your comments to tell me whether you think that Hang Seng has reversed, and what's your thoughts about the China stock market as well. All right. And I see you in my next video. Remember to click that subscribe button and like button if you like the content.